What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan Sean, and today I'm about to go over how to get over 1,000 people at your event. As you guys know, or some of you guys know, I did an indoor music festival April 1st, and of course got over 1,000 people, and people want to know how I did that, particularly Spongy Goodness and Hunter's Blog TV. I think I said that right. You can thank them too for doing this video. Go ahead and share if you think this stuff is helpful, but here we go. Number one, and one of the most important parts in my eyes, is targeted omnipresence. So you've heard me talk about the idea of omnipresence, the idea of being everywhere to everybody, but when you have minimal resources, targeted omnipresence is picking a group that's most relevant to you and being everywhere to those people. So obviously, whoever that group is, you have to figure out where they congregate, where do they hang out. So that might be a basketball court or some mall, or, but obviously this is 2017, so social media was huge for my team. And usually when you're talking about omnipresence, being everywhere all the time, you also have to think about high volume strategies a lot of times. And that's what we did, posting for about a month and a half, and at some points even posting 4 times in a day. Number two, entertain. If you're gonna be in people's face a lot, you have to entertain them. So if you looked at a lot of our promo, I'll show a few, pop some up or whatever, there was a lot of content, but all the content didn't even really say, hey, there's this festival, Adventure Time ATL on April 1st. A lot of the content was just strictly entertainment, and we just had Adventure Time ATL subliminally in the background, right? It was either the hashtag or maybe it was the logo, but a lot of it, we were providing value in different ways. So some of it was me finding some really awesome songs that I knew people would love, but they weren't really known like that. And also I spent time searching on the internet and I made little clips of those videos and those songs. And then I would put Adventure Time hashtag at the end of the clip or things like that. So then people get all this value and they're like, man, what's this song? Known and associated with this good song or good music that people like but they've never heard, so they keep giving you attention in that way. That's one way. And then I had a lot of content that was funny. People like laughing. Most of the pages that have a lot of people following them and people have no idea who the person is behind the page, they're usually humor blogs or just meme type pages. So I utilize that to our advantage.
Could you all please put down your pens and bring your papers to the front of the room? Oh, I'm sorry, you're too late. You failed. Sorry.
Excuse me, do you know who I am?
I have absolutely no idea.
Good.
So at the end of the day, only about 30% of our marketing was hard Adventure Time ATLs on April 1st at 8 o'clock, ends at 1:30. The rest of it was pretty much providing value, engaging, and being a part of the community that you want to come out and support you. And what is important about that 30% is it needs to be branded very strong though and interesting in itself. You want to curate that very specifically and guard that brand with your life. So we had a guy, one of the homies on the team, that was dedicated specifically to making sure the brand was consistent and right. Number three, we had a team. Right, you need an organized team to really do something at scale and be effective. You gotta have a team. So going back to thinking about that targeted omnipresence, we had about 5 people consistently posting within this demographic at the same time on certain days, right? Might be 3 o'clock on Thursday, 5 people post, and a lot of us have the same followers, so some of those people are going to see it like 4 times in a row, so they can't miss it. But then some days we'll have people do it spread out because everybody is on Instagram at the same time, so you might have 5 people post 5 different times throughout the day, and then you have this even harder combination leading up to the event, where it might be, I don't know, this day we have two times that we post at the same time, and then the last post, just everybody posts at a random time. Anything that you can do to gain people's attention and max out how much they see you. We even had media. You want media type people, whether they're photographers, journalists, podcasts, all those people to come out if you want an event with 1,000+ people, because one, they like to share the things that they'll be a part of, because that's just what they do. That's what media does. They promote things and they promote what they've been a part. They cover things in general. But then also, you want as much coverage as possible for this event, because after the event, do not forget, after the event, you need proof that you made this happen. Because even if you make it happen, the people who don't know you outside, they need to see that you did it. They need to see pictures. They need all types of evidence and data. And now we're already in talks with big liquor sponsors and some other legitimate big names. And another part of that is doing a sponsors packet. I can show you guys what that looks like at another time. Too much right now. You know what to do. Subscribe. There it is, up in that corner somewhere. Click it, click it.